Harper Audio presents Emily the Strange, Stranger and Stranger by Rob Reger and Jessica Gruner, performed by Angela Goethals. Copyright 2010, Cosmic Debris, etc., Inc. Production copyright 2010, HarperCollins Publishers. May 27th. Procrastination units, 13. New diaries started, 1. Boxes packed, 0. I'm starting a new diary as a way to put off packing all my stuff into boxes, like Mom has been asking and asking and asking me to do for the past 5 days. I'm not super happy about moving again. Was kind of enjoying the town of Bland and Dull. Yes, it may be bland and dull, but I've finally made it my own. Had settled into a strict routine of late-night prowls around town with the cats, daredevil skateboarding, virtuo-spastic guitar sessions on the roof, crazed feral mural art, and a touch of harmless public prankery. Summer is practically here. The nights are balmy, and I am young, and I would much rather be up to unauthorized outdoor-style mischief than sitting in my room packing boxes as instructed. Later. Am back. Got interrupted by knock on bedroom door. Mom. Assured her I was packing. Am not packing. Am headed outside. Later. I'm loitering in bushes outside Zenith's junk shop and feeling terrible future nostalgia for this place and its lovely, lovely dumpsters, which have given me so many treasures over the past several months. I'm having trouble keeping Sabbath quiet. He has a crush on Zenith's cat, Fiona, and wants the world to know. Oh, here comes Zenith now. Later. I'm now hunkered down behind someone's garage. Zenith is torn up that we are moving. Not just because I was his best customer, but because he has a sad, unrequited crush on my golem. Had to advise him that Raven was unlikely to call him from our new town, and that he should really set his sights on a human woman instead. We let Sabbath and Fiona enjoy some alone time while I took a last tour around the shop. Me. Thanks for letting me do all my shopping in the middle of the night, man. Zenith.
Yeah, well, what other time of day are you gonna need a replacement control grid for a tube amp?
Me. Or a new electrostatic ion thruster for my favorite slingshot. Zenith.
Or a blacklight painting of Marlena Dietrich.
Yeah, Zenith's been good to me. We'll have to think of a nice going-away present for him. May 28th. Procrastination units, 23. Boxes packed, 7. Cats discombobulated, 4. The packing effort has begun, but slowly. No thanks to the cats. They know what it means when the cardboard boxes come out and are even less excited to be moving than I am. I'm enduring a lot of passive-aggressive feline behavior right now. For example, 1. Violent headbutts from Sabbath are making it tough for me to write in my journal. Legibly, anyway. 2. Miles has shredded 17 cardboard boxes. Now I have to go scrounge through the supermarket dumpsters for 17 more. 3. Any boxes left open and empty, and not shredded by Miles, have been disgustingly defiled by Nietzsche. 4. Mystery has developed an uncanny talent for falling asleep on whatever it is I'm planning to pack next. 5. When not doing any of the above, all 4 have been milling about the room yelling, "Now, now, now," at me. 6. Whatever it is that they want to happen now is totally unclear, 7. Bowls of kibble and water have been spilled all over the floor. I refuse to say what is happening with the cat box. 8. Mom thinks I am not feeding the cats since they are going to her and demanding handouts of snack treats. 9. Rolls of packing tape have been chewed to sticky shreds, have had to tie up my boxes with twine like they did in the olden days. 10. Am not enjoying peaceful four feline blanket while I sleep. No, the felines are spending our prime nightmare hours clawing my face and biting my scalp instead. 11. Drastic increase in number of cat puke puddles. 12. Cat puke puddles contain more of my hair than they really should. 13. Unspeakable stench on 73% of my belongings. Later. I'm completely sick of my room, my stuff, and all those empty boxes which do nothing but mock me. Have consulted the magic 8-ball for advice, and the answer was very clear. Can't someone else do it? Have instructed Raven to pack up all the boxes. I really don't expect much on that front. Nevertheless, I'm heading outside for blessed prankery and general neighborhood goodbyes. Later. Cats and I are sprawled out on the steps of City Hall, pretending to be protesting something. We'd probably be attracting a lot of attention if it weren't the middle of the night. I'm glad that Blandindul's population has an early bedtime. I'm future nostalgic for that aspect of this place. I'm afraid we may end up in a town that prides itself on having a thriving nightlife. Blah! Okay, I'm moving on to prank time. I'm planning a little revenge on Drew and Sherry, these ridiculous lowballs down the block who like to drive around town in the middle of the night with their car absolutely full of smoke, narrowly missing feline pedestrians. We'll show them what fear tastes like. Later. Have just recovered from long fit of intense belly-busting laughter at Drew and Sherry's expense. It was perfect. I'd made a special batch of invisible ink that only shows up when it's exposed to smoke. Then I used it to paint sinister faces on their car windows. Then I followed them on my skateboard so I wouldn't miss any of the action. As soon as the air inside the car got foul enough, pop! The spooky faces appeared on all the windows. And then, Drew and Sherry freaked out, as expected. And then crash! They promptly banged into a phone pole. I called in an anonymous tip to the police and bailed. Life is good here! I do not want to move. Later, back in my disaster of a bedroom. Returned to find that Raven had packed all the empty boxes inside one another, like Russian nesting dolls. Man, Raven truly is the Amelia Bedelia of the golem world. Am irked at self for not giving better instructions. Later. Have started to catalog and dismantle all the science projects in progress in my room. Here are some of the more interesting ones. 1. Prototype of English to Catlish translator. 2. Method of connecting my magic 8-ball to electronic reader boards across the nation so that everyone can get the benefits of its amazing advice. 3. Partially completed sun spigot, which I hope will allow me to keep plants alive in my sunproof bedroom. 4. Tests of various waste products, cat hair, lint, eyelashes, dirty dish scrapings, dead flies, and their suitability as building materials when highly compressed. 5. Jar of liquid black rock that I got from my ancestral home. Have been carefully pondering potential uses for it, as it is too precious to experiment with frivolously. 6. superior hair color for mom, so she can quit the hair color-related panics she goes into every 3 weeks or so when the pink isn't pink enough or the blue isn't blue enough. 7. No drip candlestick. It's made of a special metal I created myself, which is so phenomenally dense, so incredibly heavy, that no matter how you try to tilt this candlestick, it always points straight down toward the center of the earth. Goodbye, unwanted wax drips. Unfortunately, I would need a crane to lift it, and if dropped, it would probably fall straight through the floorboards and bury itself in substrata rock far beneath the earth's surface. Small details to iron out. 8. Theremin wind chime. 9. Improvement on the cat cams I'm already using. It's great to be able to review what the cats have seen and done each day, but I need cat cams that also deliver painful shocks to anyone, besides me, who touches one of my posse. 10. Treadmill that the cats can use to generate electricity and start earning their keep around here. The treadmill works great. I just can't figure out how to motivate cats to use it. 11. Coding that will give Raven a little more initiative. I mean, I realize she is just a golem and can only do what she's programmed for. And I appreciate how she follows my every command, I really do. The thing is, it takes forever to give her all the commands she needs for even the simplest tasks. It's one thing to get her to hold a cavity resonator steady for me while I spit shine it, but ask her to tidy up the room and it's just blank stares and, huh? All I'm saying is, it would be nice to get a more holistic approach to the whole command thing, and I wouldn't mind if she could maybe interpret hints and suggestions. You know, I'm only one person. I could use some help around here. 12. Laundry detergent that blackens even the whitest of clothing. 13. Duplication device. Just think of the mischief I can get into when this little beauty is finally functional. Ah, someday. Rubbing hands together, cackling madly. Later. Have had a brainwave. Am going to donate all my belongings to science and begin anew after the move. Yes! Anew! This solves the entire packing problem. We'll call science tomorrow and have them back a truck up to the house. Am feeling very brilliant. Sun is rising. Time for bed. May 29th. Procrastination units, 123. Boxes packed, 8. Belongings donated to science, 0. I'm not sure what I was thinking yesterday. Am donating nothing. It is all precious and it all comes. Later. Only 3 days left before we leave, and I still haven't come up with an idea for a master prank. It's always been a matter of personal pride for me to pull off at least one jaw-dropping prank of great magnitude in every town I live in, one that the townspeople will talk about for years. I'm sorry to say that bland and dull pranking has been more about quantity than quality. Sigh. I'm heading out to look for inspiration. We'll report back later. 3 minutes later, was intercepted by mom at the front door and have returned to my room to continue packing. We'll need to use bedroom window to escape house next time. Must continue packing. Later. Am back from brief, very brief, trip outdoors. Was intercepted by mom under my bedroom window. She has given me a thorough shaming. It was very cute. She has not put the effort into a real down-home shaming in a long time. Am determined to make it worth her while and pack at least one box before the night is over. Later. Finished packing one box, then was filled with glorious sense of accomplishment, then rode that sense of accomplishment right out the basement window and into the beautiful night. Have spent a few hours tooling around town with the cats. I'm now hiding out behind the hardware store watching Miles and Nietzsche cooperatively stalk rodents. It is hilariously vicious, yet non-productive, since I always intervene before things turn deadly. Best moments are when Sabbath unwittingly blows their cover, and then they cooperatively give him a beatdown. Ah, ha, 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 ha. I'm going to miss this place. Have spent months learning where the good dumpsters and rodent lairs are, and getting to know the neighbors' shortcomings and vulnerabilities so I can.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.